أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. We continue with سورة الحجرات وسورة الأخلاق وسورة المجتمع. مجتمع means society, community. أخلاق means manners and morals, the code of ethics. الحجرات means the rooms of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Referring to the rooms of Rasulullah. And each of those names have a relationship, has a relationship with the theme of the surah. The reason of the revelation, because those people came, as we talked last time, talking about calling Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was resting his houses in a manner that they were not supposed to. And Allah Azza Jal talks about the society and how the behavior of the members of the Muslim society should be and how the society should function as a whole. All right? How they should behave listening to Rasulullah, how they should behave not raising their voices in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we talked about the life of Rasulullah and after Rasulullah, same thing, his sunnah should be respected and dealt with exactly the same way. Also, when two groups of the Muslim community, they are disputing or fighting, Islam told us also the problem or the conflict resolution is based on this Surah Al-Hujurat. طبعا, it is mentioned in everywhere in the Quran, conflict resolution between husband and wife, conflict resolution in the family, conflict resolution between enemies based on religion and so on. That's mentioned in Quran. And Surah Al-Hujurat, conflict resolution within the Muslim community. And this is in the ayah, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Then Allah Azza wa Jal told us that the ukhuwa or the brotherhood of faith, it surpasses or precedes or supersedes everything else. It supersedes everything else. Subhanallah, today somebody talked to me about some issue with his wife. And this is again a practical example of sometimes how we look at things, emotionally speaking. So he's saying that, you know, how his wife complains about him not loving her and all of that. And how he's saying that, you know, he loves her and all that. Then I told her, do you love her? I asked him, do you love your wife? He said, you know, she's my wife of 20 years, ya Shaykh, she's the mother of my children. I like her. I said, do you love your wife? And he kept repeating the same question. Then he asked me, what do you mean, ya Sheikh? I told him, exactly. He said, what? I told him, exactly. I don't mean anything. You know, if she tell you that you, do you love me, and you don't know what it is, say, yes, I do. But save yourself the issue of defining what is love and what is this. For you, for the man in general, and this is a secret I'm going to reveal to all my sisters today. Okay? Men in general, they do not know love as women do. Okay? And I can say this in CNN. يعني. All right? There is no way. If a man writes on paper what he means by loving a woman and a woman writes, they're completely different. Anybody try otherwise, they're just becoming politically correct. Alright? And I'm going to tell you so we can live in peace after today, inshallah. Peace treaty. Okay? So when a man say, I love you, means I care about you. I respect your company. You mean a lot to me. Without you, I cannot function properly. You see? This is what a man means. Practical things. No fantasies. No fantasies included. He is speaking reality. Reality. He's saying that you are the most important person in my life. That is love for me. I go work, you wait for me, I have children with you, you have been there with me through thick and thin. That is love. Now, woman is love, is a different thing. You know, flowers and pink stuff, unicorns flying, you know? And you nice and dandy, touchy-touchy, all these kind of things. So if a woman asks a man, do you love me? What comes in your head, my brothers? The list I give you, right? What is in her head? What I just told you, okay? So when you are saying, yes, I do, honey, you are actually lying. in her on her skin. And that's why Rasulullah said. But I want you to understand, because at the time of conflict. Why I'm saying all of this? That is called conflict resolution. Conflict resolution is understanding each other. Okay? So when a man, his wife asks him, I love you, don't interpret it the way you do. Right? And when he says, yes, I do, I want you to understand the way we do. Make sense? Fahimt ab sabur? Because you are the news guy over here. Okay? Alright? I'm just telling you, like, now. So, alhamdulillah. So, conflict resolution between husband and wife and all that. So, I told him, ya akhi, all of this means love and means nothing else. But she does not understand that. She just wants to hear the word, yes, I love you. That's it. She's not going to ask you about interpretation. She's not going to ask you what you mean. She's not going to ask anything. She asks the question, you answer the question. Simple. Alas. Well, that's the state answer. Yes, I do. What do you think? Come on, you know. If I don't love you, who else I love? Now you are a superstar. Not a normal husband. No, you are husband plus. So, if we do this individually, then family, then community, then jama'ah, then we'll not have the two groups fighting each other. If we understand. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla said, always have to be the third group in the middle who understands, bring them together. That today, Allah Azza wa Jalla telling us the things that we have to avoid. I told you in the beginning, لا, 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 remember? لا تقدموا, لا ترفعوا, لا يسخر. سخرية, mocking, being sarcastic. But it is mocking, you know, mocking someone for a shortcoming or defect. You know, like someone is trying and says, ha ha ha, look at that. That's yaskhar. Making fun of somebody. Exactly. This is the simplest of terms. But you know what? Sukhriya can be with the eye also. You know what I mean? Sukhriya can be with the eye. Yeah, you can just give them the stern look or the disgusted look, you know? Or the mocking look, like, you know, somebody standing there and you are looking at them and saying, waiting for them to make a mistake. Yaskhar. Or they are talking and you are like, I don't care about what you're saying. So all expression also, that's why humaza, lumaza, with the action and with the gesture. La yaskhar, qawmun. Min qawmin, no group of men should make sukhriya. And Allah here emphasized men and women separately. And every time that comes in the Quran means it is big time emphasized. So don't think that whatever the rule here, women follow, but the men are the ones addressed. Allah said no, both of you are addressed. La yaskhar qawmun min qawm, yani men. Wala nisa'un min nisa'. Why? Maybe the person you are mocking is way better than you. Is way better than you. I told you the hadith before. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us there was a woman breastfeeding her child. And then, you know, when the child was breastfed, and then, you know, a man goes with a horse and a big shakl. And then she said, ya Allah, make my son like him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is one of the boys who spoke in the cradle. He lifted the breast of his mother and he said, ya Allah, don't make me like him. Then he went back to breastfeed again. Or Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that he meant it literally by putting his thumb in his own mouth, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying that's how the kid were suckling. He said then the kid went back. He did like this, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he said, and he left his mother's breast and he took his thumb out. So when a girl or a young woman passing by and they are beating her up, the people, and said, you commit adultery, you steal, you are a bad woman. So she said, ya Allah, don't make my son like her. And the son said, ya Allah, make me like her. She told him, what is wrong with you? He said, the first one is an arrogant, bad person. And the other one that you mocked and you do not want me to be like, she is innocent. And she is a pious, righteous servant of Allah. Allah make him speak. What I'm trying to say is sometimes you mock someone and that person is way better than you. And sometimes you overestimate someone and they are actually very low. They don't deserve it. So that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ اتقاكم. At the end of the ayah, right? لا يسخر قوم من قوم حسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم. You don't know. Why are you mocking people? Subhanallah. One time, a person, when we were young, we were in elementary school, and our teacher was not only a teacher, subhanallah, Shaykh Muhammad Abdu, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him. He taught us how to be human beings and how to be good Muslims when we were young. That's why you don't forget that kind of teacher. So one time, we are laughing at someone who had a physical disability. One of the children, as kids, and then that kid was trying to do something and he failed because of his disability. Our cultures are very retarded cultures when it comes to people with disability. I'm just honestly saying, until this day, anybody with a handicap or disability, as if it is their mistake. They should be punished for it and should be eliminated. Astaghfirullah, what is this? I love the way the United States and the West, they deal with this. That is the rule of Islam, wallahi. They handle anybody with handicap and disability. They even have a law that you cannot discriminate against them and you can be in trouble if you don't give it, right? So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, La yasghar qawm. So we left at that person when he fell down because he couldn't do something. So the Shaykh or the Ustaz told us, why are you laughing? He said, are you mocking him or are you mocking Allah who created him like this? That is never, I never forgot that one. So the first thing comes in my head is that incident whenever I read this ayah. Every time. It makes me cry, Allah, sometimes. Even when you were young, يعني, Allah will not account you for what you did when you were young. But there is an image associated. You mocked someone that Allah created them like that. Okay? So are you mocking the person or are you mocking the one who created him like this? So be careful. أتعيب الخلق أم تعيب الخالق؟ Are you mocking the creation or the creator? So be careful. لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى. This ayah also there is a reason of its revelation. Those people when they come, they looked at the Sahaba of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the poor ones sitting in the masjid. أهل الصفة, they have very poor clothes, they have meager food and all that. So they laughed at them. They said, oh, you are the followers of Muhammad. These are the followers of Muhammad. Look at us and all this. So Allah said, لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا. And عسى in Quran, it is not only perhaps. It has emphasis. يعني actually the ones you mocked, they are better than you. يعني when you mock someone Muslim, and you mock them, now you went lower because the person who mocked someone lost a lot of their iman on the spot. So that actually makes the one mocked better than you automatically. So the asa according to this does not mean perhaps, that means you just made them better than you by mocking them. Make sense now logically? So whenever you mock someone, they are better than you right there because they were the subject of your sin. You just committed the sin and you get them reward. So who's better now? The one who gets the reward or the one who gets the sin? The one who gets the reward. So if you backbite someone, you just make them better than you. If you mock someone, you just make themselves better than you. So the word asa here does not mean perhaps. That's why the scholar said, whenever asa comes associated with Quran, it means for sure this is the case. Right? Abdullah ibn Abbas said that. So anyways, لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكون خيرا منهم. Also, they said ثابت بن قيس بن شماس, that is a صحابي of Rasulullah, the same one that was a loud voice. He had an argument with another companion, and then he reminded that companion with his mother in Jahiliyyah. His mother in Jahiliyyah was kind of like something that a person would be shy from, right? Shy of. So he reminded him, so the person put his head down. He was embarrassed. And the Rasulullah ﷺ did not like that. And this ayah also emphasized on this aspect. I told you before, reason of revelation, sabab al-nuzul, means two things. One, an incident happened and the verse is revealed because of the incident, or the verse is revealed and it applies to more than one incident. You get it? So سبب النزول, the reason of revelation, يعني that ayah is revealed to to put a standard for few incidents happen. So whenever you see سبب نزول this, you say which one actually. So that means we don't understand the word سبب نزول. سبب means reason. Reason of revelation means the verse is revealed because of that specific one, or that ayah will apply to more than one issue related to it. You get it? Yeah, so that's why you find more than one reason sometimes, so don't get confused. Also, it says that Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl, who's his father again? Abu Jahl. But Ikrimah was a companion of the Prophet now. Abu Jahl died in Badr. Ikrimah accepted Islam after Fath Mecca, you know, after Khalid ibn Walid and all of that. So he accepted Islam. So the Sahaba used to laugh at him that you are the son of Abu Jahl. Oh, son of Abu Jahl came, son of Abu Jahl went, right? This ayah came where Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam حذرهم. قال, don't call him by his father's name. You know, don't do that. Now, he went and complained to Rasulullah. So anyways, as I told you, many incidents, but the ayah applies to all of them. طيب, what about the women? يعني the verse, لا يسخر قوم من قوم about men. I told you the reason. But what about women? Safiyyah, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The women in Medina and the wives of Rasulullah, the other wives, used to tell her, you were a Jew and your parents were Jews. As mocking them down, mocking her. You are not born and raised Muslim. Right? Even though this is, but still, يعني some of the jahiliya ways still remain. People like, oh, which one family? Oh, your family like this, like that, like, you know, like this. So, يقولون لا يهودية بنت يهوديين. You are a Jew and daughter, even though now she is Muslim. Okay? And even if you do not tell them like that. She came and complained to Rasulullah. Said, Ya Rasulullah, she crying. Did they tell me this? He says, if anybody tell you this, next time, tell them, Abi Harun wa Ammi Musa wa Zawji Muhammad. My father is Harun, and my uncle is Musa, and my husband is Muhammad. Who among you has these three prophets? You see the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam giving her comfort. Wallahi, when I read these things, I say, what kind of man is this? He cares about the feeling of everybody around him. Everyone, young or old, he will not leave them alone. Will always give them a badge of honor. Something to empowerment. People pay thousands of dollars to go get empowered now. But the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was teaching us to give it for free. Give positive energy. That's what they say, right? Positive energy. And Safiya, when she's coming and crying, waiting for that. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, okay, honey, everything will be okay. Everything will be all right. Instead, he gave her something to top everybody. عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهُنْ. Now she became better than everybody now. Father is Harun. She's from the offspring of Harun. And her uncle is Musa. Alayhi salam. And her husband is who? Last prophet. And everybody else does not have two prophets in their lineage and married to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فهذه واحدة. Also, some of the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to call Ummu Salama shorty. She's short. Shorty. Ya qasira. And when somebody said, hey shorty, right? Hey fatty, hey shorty. This is haram in Islam to do that. When the person does not like it. If it is a family name, it's okay. You have a family name, but family name. خلاص, a family name. Okay, family name. It is not that word anymore. In Arabic, that's what it is. We have a family in Egypt called al-Baghl. Baghl يعني mule. Right? And a family called al-Jahsh. Jahsh means the donkey. Yeah, في كده family. The man, his name is Jahsh. يعني if you call somebody جحش, this is, means stupid, you mean, you know, retarded, things like that. But the family جحش, very rich family, you know. Now people will say, أنا من عيلة الجحش, I am جحش. You cannot say that he's saying I'm a donkey. The name now got out from what it literally means, became for a person. Other than that, you cannot call a person جحش. You cannot call a person mule. You understand? You cannot do that. Say, he works like a mule. No, he works like a man. Okay? Don't say like a mule. Because mule is an animal. وَاللَّهَ كَرَّمَ بَنِي آدَمَ وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. No. So, الله عز وجل said ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب. So أم سلمة wife of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم like this. عائشة herself. One time she did not even say. Safiya also was shorter than average. So two wives of Rasulullah were shorter. Umm Salama was a little bit older woman. Safiya was very beautiful, you know, very beautiful. So she was a competition to Aisha radiallahu anha. Competition. Zainab was even more. So they were competing with each other. One time Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is talking about Safiya. So Aisha did like this. Bas, she did like this. Yani she is. She didn't say it. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, you made something, if it is a word and is mixed with the water of the ocean, it will make it impure. All the word of the ocean will become like ink. Yani.
The gesture
itself.
Converted into words.
Yeah, it will spoil all the water of the world. So don't do that. فَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. تنابز نبزة يعني shooting something, throwing something at someone. نبزة. فنبز إليهم على سواء. لا, this is different. لا, نبزة. تنابز بالألقاب. نبزة. يعني you call each other with the thing that you hate. Like somebody throwing a stone. Like for example, a person said, يا فاسق. Oh, adulterer. Oh, this. Oh, that. Or you are a low level. Who you think you are, you know, this kind of tanabuz bil alqab. Or a title that people had in jahiliya, and now they become good, repented to Allah, or become practicing Muslim, don't call them with the name that connotation or associated with wrongdoing. Hada tanabuz bil alqab. Wala tanabazu bil alqab. Bi'sal ism, worst of names is to be called a fasiq after you become a Muslim. After you become a Muslim, somebody said, yeah, fasiq. This is not right. Wallahi, one brother one time from Caribbean, he told me, wallahi, ya Shaykh, when I grew up, I remember people were ignorant so much with the Quran that they opened the Quran and whatever name there, they named their children. They named their child. He said, wallahi, a brother named his son Fasiq. Fasiq. You know, he's Fisq. Because he doesn't know what Fasiq means. And then somebody told him, you know what this means? He said, no, a Quran word. Means all Quran words good, yani. Quran has Fir'aun also. that's not good. One time, somebody said, Shaykh, what are the names of your children? I said, the names. And I said at the end, Musa and Harun. They said, inshallah, you're going to get Fir'aun soon. I said, wallahi, akh, watch what you're saying. He said, I'm joking. He said, this is not a joke, akh. You don't joke about this. You know, I get, يعني, you want me to get someone like Fir'aun, or you are saying the name, يعني. It's not funny. But you understand? يعني, yeah, he laughed and everything, and I laughed too, but I told him that's not funny, don't do this. Allah said, وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. يعني, what do you mean by a Muslim getting a son, his name is Fir'aun? What does that mean? What does it mean, really, يعني? What does it mean? So don't do like that. So laqab also is like you tell somebody, يَا أَعْوَر, one-eyed, or ya a'raj, you know, limping, or this. Don't do that. لا تنابزوا بالألقاب. They are better than you, يا أخي. You just made them better than you. By thinking to say that, they're already better than you. بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب. You have to repent to Allah عز وجل. ومن لم يتب فأولئك ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. ظالم, you know, a transgressor, subhanAllah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, the one comes after that. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ijtanibu, right? Ijtanibu kathiran min al-dhanni inna ba'd al-dhanni. Because some of your assumption is negative, you need to avoid most of the assumption. You see the mathematical equation here? Because some of this food is not good, so you need to avoid the whole food. Make sense? يعني you open a watermelon and you find a small piece which is not good. What do? You cut around it big piece. Yes or no? You make sure, right? So a small place in the table is not clean, you clean the whole thing. There is a stain, you clean the stain, then you wash the whole clothes. Why are you doing all this? All these are extra measures not to give chance for negative. When even they do operation, you know, if the cancer or tumor or something, the doctor makes sure around it also is what? Clean. That is what Allah is saying. اجتنبوا what? كثيراً. كثيراً يعني a lot of your assumption. Why? إن بعض. Some of it is bad. So avoid most because some of it will be bad, but you don't know which one. So you have the cup, part of it is not good, but I'm not going to drink the whole thing. خلاص, that's it. Because I don't want to touch the part that I don't know where. Okay, that's why when you close, you know that the clothes have najasa in it, but you don't know which part, you wash the whole thing. Okay? So, اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن, ظن, assumption. Always give the benefit of the doubt in a positive way. Subhanallah, wallahi, this is an exercise we can spend the whole Ramadan trying to improve on. When somebody say something or do something, always give them excuse. Can we try to do that, inshallah? Huh? Today's lesson will be perfect, inshallah, if we do that. Anybody does something to you, you think it is negative, try to give them a good excuse and see how you feel. Shaitan will fight you like crazy. I'm telling you. Sometimes I'm in the masjid and I'm talking to someone and someone passes by and I'm looking at them. And then they come later on, they said, Shaykh, you ignored me. I said, wallahi, I didn't ignore you. He said, yesterday. I said, I didn't see you yesterday. He said, no, you looked at me and face. I said, maybe, but I really did not see you. You know, this happens, right? So, اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. Why you jump to the conclusion that I looked at you, I recognized you, and then I ignored you? You see how many steps? Ya akhi, give me some excuse. Say, the Shaykh maybe saw me, recognized me, and ignored me for a reason. Yani, if you could not find the reason, say, maybe he did what I thought is wrong, but for a reason. So I'm going to go ask him. You see how far you can go? Like that. Instead of jumping to negative. Oh, they are looking at me because they are jealous. Oh, they are looking at me because they are jealous. Always negative, 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 negative. Why? Maybe they have something else. إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ. What is the next? وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا. Spying. You know? Even between husband and wife. You cannot wiretap the phone. You cannot record the conversation. You cannot put a camera to see what your wife is doing in your absence. You can't do that. You cannot. Unless you are putting for security and both know and both have access. No problem. Wallahi, I get cases you cannot imagine. You cannot imagine. The sisters are crying, yani, deeply, hard. Why? Because the husband is surveilling her everywhere she goes. Why, akhi? Why? يعني والله giving her talaq is much better than this. Making her feel like she is criminal. She is a criminal, you know? لا. امساكم بمعروف أو تسريح إحسان. Either you keep with goodness or leave with goodness. But not like this. Doubt from both sides, not good. A wife put a tracker on the phone, huh? Or the car, or something like that. Or make the husband sleep. She takes his thumb finger and put it in the phone. And she watches. Mamdouh, forbidden, haram, sinful. I'm telling you right now, if phone is left there, even without a password, you cannot take it and check the photos and stuff. You can't do that. Husband cannot do that for his wife. Wife cannot do that for husband. Am I clear today? Yeah, because I don't want this issue to keep coming up from good people. It keeps coming up from good people. You can't do that. My daughters are sitting there in front of you. Ask them, when is the last time my dad checked our phone? Never did. Never did. I don't take their phone behind their without their permission and check what is in it. I don't do that. That's not me. My son, I give him the car. I said, I trust you. I'm not going to put a tracker on your car. I don't want a curfew. I don't want anything. I trust you. But you betray that trust once, خلاص. It cannot be fixed again. That's the danger of it. It can be the one time I check on you, you're doing something wrong. I'll assume that you've been doing wrong all the time. If you want to risk it, risk it. That's it. Covenant, you know? Spying is the worst thing ever because you will never be satisfied. And those who put alarm system in their home know exactly what I'm saying. You cannot live without an alarm system. Can you? How many people do the alarm system and then they disable it and live clearly? You want to hear that tit 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 every time you open and close. I'm telling you about myself. Every time you open and close, you want to see the alarm working. You feel safe. Somebody have gun, خلاص, you cannot live without gun. That's it. It's over. Okay? But if you spy and you find something that you doubted and it is now you cannot trust anybody. That's why لا تجسسوا. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تجسسوا. ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. If you backbite each other, you are like eating the flesh of your dead brother. When somebody dies, your brother, your dear own brother from your father and mother died, what do? You wash them, you cover them, you bury them. You kind of like cover them, right? In here, instead of doing that, you're putting their corpse in front of you and you start digging and eating. A'uzu billah. Who would like that? That's exactly what you're doing every time you backbite. I want you to remember that picture. Subhanallah. So assume good about people, don't assume bad, and don't backbite them. Don't backbite them. Maybe another session we can talk about the exception when somebody is so bad in the community, somebody about to get married or become a partner with someone and they're going to hurt them, you can talk in their absence. That's okay because you are getting a better benefit. If somebody going to the judge or to the authority complaining about someone, that is not backbiting. If you are asking for fatwa, a husband about his wife or a wife about her husband, or asking, that's not backbiting. You know, anything that has a bigger benefit will not say it's backbiting. You got that? But in general, backbiting is horrible. Because now we don't respect. I do not know if backbiting is commonplace in the community, how should I feel safe coming here tonight? If I know the minute I step in, do-do-do-do-do. The minute I step out, do-do-do-do. Why? Why should I come? Why should I come if I am going to trigger my personal life to be the subject of people's talk? Why? You see the idea here? So it will not give us, that's why we say the surah is about society. Do you like to eat your flesh of your dead brother? لا طبعا فكرهتموه, this is bad. واتقوا الله في الله إن الله تواب رحيم. Then Allah said that we created you from a male and female, Adam and Hawa. All of us going back to Adam. And we made you tribes and nations. So don't forget, as far as you can go, remember you belong to what? To who? Adam and Hawa. O people, كلكم لآدم. All of you go to Adam. So we are all from the same father and the same mother at the end of the day. Yes, black, white, this, that, Arab, non-Arab, tall, short, rich, poor, man, woman, everything. At the end of the day, we have one common ground. Our father is Adam and our mother is Hawa. Dhakar wa unsa. Ja'allakum shu'uban wa qabail. The point is that you come back together. You know each other. Lita'arafu. Not لتنافروا. يعني now when we are different, we go away from each other. Allah said, you are different, so you can come back to each other. Complete each other. The more people get back together, the more of the qualities of Adam and Hawa come together. Do you know that? When two strangers know each other and they become so good friends, there is a feeling that you cannot describe, yes? Yes? So when two people like far, husband and wife, they become intimate with each other. So, subhanallah, he's from one side, she's from another side, but now they're very close. Why? Because you belong to Adam and Hawa, who are very close to each other. This is in some in-depth meaning, but I'm just telling you that. One person one time goes to Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, Amir Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, and he asks, but they prevent him from coming in. So he keep trying, but so one time he dressed nicely and he said, go tell Amir al-Mu'mineen that his brother in the door, on the door. I'm his brother. So he said, we don't know his brother. He said, I'm just telling you, tell him your brother is on the door. He said, which brother? This one. He said, no, there's a new guy. He said, let him in, come in. He said, are you my brother? He said, yes, I'm your brother and you are my younger brother. He said, how? He said, from Adam. I'm your brother from Adam and Hawa. قال هذا رحم قطع نصله اليوم. This is a rahim which was cut off. Today I'm going to connect it. What do you want? And then he honored him and everything. But you see the understanding, يعني? So this is كلكم لآدم وآدم من تراب. But never forget that the best of you is not based on our standard. Because if it's our standard, then I will think I'm higher because I have more knowledge than you. You think you are higher because you are richer than me or you are older than me. Everybody will have a standard. Allah said, all doesn't don't count. إن أكرمكم the most honorable among you is who? عند الله. عندي أنا ممكن because you're old, because I'm knowledgeable. That is our standard. Fine. But what counts is who are you to Allah? Not to me or to community or to country or to the world. Does not matter. You are to the world what? You will die and you're 6 feet under. What's your value after that? So what is your values with Allah? أكرمكم عند الله هو أتقاكم. And there is no way to know the taqwa except to Allah. That means is a standard only Allah will apply. How would you know that I have more taqwa than anybody else? How would you know? You don't know. So you know that only Allah can measure, and the measurement that nobody would know. So you leave it. Person next to you, you deal with him as he is more pious than you. This is the only way. So don't look down upon anybody. إن الله عليم خبير. Then you know the last section is about الأعراب. قالت الأعراب آمنا. When they come and they accepted Islam, those Bedouins, and they were hard-hearted, rude people, huh? They said, we believe, we believe, we become believer. Allah said, لا, قولوا أسلمنا. We become Muslim. When the Iman enter your heart, then you will know it, right? But it takes effort. It takes effort. ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم وإن تطيعوا الله ورسوله في أبي الله عند الرسول لا يلتكم. This word came in سورة محمد as well, دكتور خان. You know, يلت يعني means يظلم, means is not hidden, be hidden or take away from you, huh? Yeah, سورة المنافقون also. ولا يلتكم من أعمالكم شيئا, will not take away from your أعمال anything if you obey Allah and His رسول. Yes, yes, it will be recognized as long as you obey Allah and His رسول. You can do all أعمال you want. You don't obey Allah and His رسول, does not mean anything. إن الله غفور رحيم. Then Allah described what are the true believers. May Allah make us among them. Say Ameen. إنما المؤمنون, the true believers, الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا. Allah did not say ولم يرتابوا. No, He said ثم. Means it takes time until you become so sure that there is no doubt. That means some Muslim can have a doubt. Your faith is still in the works. So آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم. ثم means there is a time. لم يرتابوا, they reach the stage of conviction. They have no doubts. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. لا يرتاب في الله, لا يرتاب في الرسول, لا يرتاب في القرآن, في الدين. No ريب, no doubt. Nothing is going to affect their faith. They will say, you know what? Maybe I don't get it, but I know it is the right thing. خلاص. لا يرتاب. ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله. Understood, طبعا. They make jihad with their money and their self في سبيل الله. أولئك هم الصادقون. What is the صادق? Matching what is in their heart to what they say and what they do. That is the ultimate truthful person. Okay? Ultimate truthful. You can say, I like this tea. Beautiful. So you like it and you showed it. But in your heart you don't like it. You are not sadiq. You are not truthful. Okay? Or you dislike it from inside, but you show that you like it. Opposite, yeah. Or you like it inside, but you show you dislike it. You're lying also. So matching what is in your heart, believe in Allah and His Rasul, and you know, all of that. Saying, I believe in Allah and His Rasul, and your amal shows it. Amal shows it. That's why Allah said, وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِمْ وَأَنفُسِمْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ صَادِقُونَ. They believe in Allah and His Rasul. Okay? That's one. They are not doubting. That's two. How you will know that they are not doubting? When Rasulullah said, let's go, and you might die, and they still go, that means صادق. You know? But the munafiq, we're tired. إن بيوتنا عورة وما هي بعورة إن يريدون إلا فرارة. سورة الأحزاب, right? They said, you know why? Our houses are not this. Oh, we're afraid and we're this. I'm lying. So he said, I believe and I have no doubt. But when the action time comes, lying or truthful. Allah said what? وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ المجاهدين منكم والصابرين ونبلو أخباركم. سورة محمد. We will test you until we know who's lying and who's truthful. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم فلا يعلمن الله الذين صدقوا ولا يعلمن الكاذبين. صدق وكذب. قل أتعلمون الله بدينكم؟ Are you making a favor to Allah that you are having the deen? والله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله بكل شيء عليم. والله بكل شيء عليم. يعني for example, someone comes and they say, yeah, Shaykh, this fatwa is such and such and such. I said, you want to teach me now? I'm not asking him yes or no question here. I'm asking him a question to stop in your tracks, right? Stop in your tracks. You want to teach me now? يعني I was giving a lecture. Today's what? Wednesday? I was giving a lecture Monday somewhere about Ramadan and all that. And then somebody asked a question. And then a brother interrupted and answered him. Okay? It's very simple. Yeah. And you see, he blocked me from talking. Okay? So, saying something about a dog, you know? So one person asking a question, Ya Sheikh, sometimes a person walking with the dog and the child went and petted the dog and all of that, huh? And then we came to the masjid, what should I do? Take the child back and take shower. The brother said, you cannot pet the dog. It is haram. Right, you know? And he kept like going on and on and on. And the man was like kind of scared. And I am sitting there, mashallah, watching this. And if you touch the dog, you have to take all your clothes off. And you have to go to the shower and wash this clothes. And make sure the detergent is this. I said, what? And أنا قاعد يعني, I'm here, a clown يعني, sitting here. Today, I'm coming to entertain these people, dance for them, مثلا يعني, and you are the alim here. That will be like, are you the mufti today? That is the same question. قل أتعلمون الله بدينكم. يعني you're going to teach Allah now? What is the deal? والله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض. والله بكل شيء عليم. Then يمنون عليك أن أسلموا. They tell Rasulullah, now become Muslim. You should be proud. All of this kind of thing. لا. قل لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم. بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان. يعني say, الحمد لله the one who guided us to the deen. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا. وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Allah is the one who got it. الحمد لله. It's not because I'm smart. It's not because I'm knowledgeable. لا والله. I'm not sitting here because I'm knowledgeable. I studied. I didn't know. Because tawfiq of Allah. Allah is the one who brought me here. So he is the one who has the favor. He is the one who gets the credit. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. The credit. Anybody after that is because the tawfiq of Allah. I'm here because tawfiq of Allah. You are studying Quran because tawfiq of Allah. Nothing else. So always remember that. بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنْ هَدَاكُمْ لِلْإِيمَانِ بَلِ اللَّهُ يَمُنُّ عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان إن كنتم صادقين. If you are truthful about what you say, Allah is the one who calls the credit. Allah is the one who claims the credit سبحانه وتعالى. والرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, one time the Ansar were debating about something, then he comes to them and say, يا معشر الأنصار, O people of الأنصار, ألم أجدكم ضلالا فهداكم الله بي. Didn't I find you deviated and stray and Allah guided you with me because of me? وكنتم متفرقين, you were divided, فألفكم الله بي, Allah united you with me because of me. وكنتم عالة, you were poor, فأغناكم الله بي, Allah will give you the wealth because of me. قالوا بلى والله بلى الله ورسوله أمن وأفضل. Allah and His Rasul are the ones who are worthy to remind us with the favor. Rasulullah was not trying to, because the rest of the hadith he said, if you wish, you would have said the same about me. You were alone, but we give you help, support, and you would be truthful. So the Sahaba started crying, right? Because he said, this is what you need to focus on. Allah guided you. Allah brought you up. Allah chose you to be the Ansar of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shouldn't worry about other things. Right? So that's what he was trying to teach them. He said, for the favor, everybody can call favors, right? But Allah and His Rasul are the ones who are worthy of the favor. If Rasulullah stand and said, Allah guided all of you because of me. He said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. Yes, of course. Okay? He's the only one who can claim that. صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاثة آية: إن الله يعلم غيب السماوات والأرض. يعلم is present tense continuous. Present tense continuous. You know like يعلم يعني علم ويعلم وسيعلم وهو عالم. إن الله يعلم. He knows. At the time the Quran was revealed and at the time you recite it, at the time if everybody recited it, it is like a renewable verb. يعني whenever you say it, I say it now, I say it after 1 hour, it is the same, right? إن الله يعلم. إن الله يعلم غيب السماوات والأرض. The unseen of heavens and earth instantaneously. No other entity would know everything instantaneously. Even the security guard in a big building has like 20 screens. He cannot look at all the 20 screens instantaneously. Can he do that? Can any human do that? There is no way. If human can do that, can they analyze? Can they relate? Can they connect? Can they find the conclusion? No. Even يعني, if somebody does, which is impossible, but still will fail in something. But Allah does everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu basirun. بما تعملون. Allah Azza wa Jal is always seeing and watching what you do. This ayat here is showing us not to feel that you are doing Allah a favor, not you doing Rasulullah a favor. You are not doing anybody a favor except for yourself. That's number one. Number two, if you criticize someone, you are hurting no one but yourself. So if you are claiming credit, you have no credit. And if you are criticizing someone, you are actually criticizing yourself. So the best way out is what? Always give the credit to Allah Azza wa Jal and always assume good about others. That is the outcome of the whole thing of today, right? So inshallah Rabbil Alameen, maybe after Ramadan, when we come back again inshallah, I'm going to give the summary of Surah Al-Hujurat before we give the introduction to the other surah. 5 minutes kida inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the people of Surah Al-Hujurat who listen and who learn. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وجزاكم الله خيرا for listening.